We're with Delaware head coach K.C. Keeler. And coach, that's a Maine team that came in with 5 sacks on the year today. They were able to get to Trent Hurley 9 times. Obviously, a young offensive line, but having some issues right now.
Yeah, you know, first 4 weeks we got better every week. And, you know, gave up some things in that New Hampshire game, but this was a lot worse this game. And, you know, I mean, it starts up front. If you're not going to play well up front, it's going to be a long day. And, you know, Trent's about half of what he was early in the season. And so, you know, he's not given us as much ability to make plays with his feet. He made some today. And you talk about a gutty performance. I mean, I can't even tell you, you know, how banged up that kid is. And we're going to cast him right after the game and try to get that foot right. But he gives us our best chance to win. And even with him at, 80% or so, I mean, his ability to escape the pocket still helps us. But he's obviously not the player he was earlier in the season.
Speaking of injuries, you have to go out there without Andrew Pierce. He plays a few snaps, but not very much. When did you find out that Pierce would not be able to go, and how did that change your game plan?
That was like a game day thing where we found out Thursday, tweaked his hamstring. Obviously, we're out without David Hayes. We have a very talented freshman. That's got a little bit of a knee issue. And so Julian's been our 4th. And so we really had to bring over Walter Davis and Leon Jackson to just make sure we had, you know, someone else that could go in case Julian went down.
Defensively, some missed tackles, particularly on those first few drives by Maine. Was the defense a little flat? You talked about not letting New Hampshire beat you twice. Did you get that feeling at all?
No, it wasn't that. You know, I mean, I think our kids played a little soft with the wind into Maine's face. We should have probably been a little bit more aggressive. We gave them too many things underneath, and we missed some tackles. But it's all, you know, when they're blocking better than you and tackling better than you, I mean, they have a better chance of winning, and they blocked and tackled better than we did. So, you know, but again, that first drive, I think, was a big part of setting the tone for the game, because you only have so much time with the wind in your face. That win was significant in terms of playing football, and you know, they did a great job with their first drive. You know, hindsight, the corner should have been a little bit more aggressive and knew the shorter routes were going to be there, but they let them hit them on some short stuff and then missed some tackles. It's concerning. You know, I mean, I know it's a compliment with your offense and your defense, and our offense just isn't getting things done, and I think part of that is obviously, you know, losing some of the firepower we've lost. But also, it's we need to play better on the offensive line.
Finally, tough way to go into what you call the get better week. A long stretch before that next game. How do you deal with this team in terms of trying to keep their psyche up?
Yeah, I mean, as I told them, I said, you know, we can call Rhode Island right now, and we can call Richmond and Villanova and Old Dominion and see if they'll, you know, cancel the season. I said, I don't know if they will or not. I said, so we might have to come and play these guys. So, it's, you know, it's up to you. We have 5 weeks left. We have 5 weeks left, and how are you going to attack this thing? And it's going to be a great challenge for our leadership to see how we do this. So tremendously disappointing because, you know, we knew we were a little, you know, not outmanned, but we knew we were going to be a little shorthanded, and we thought, boy, if we can get through this one, we can get some people healthy and get into this next week, you know, this Rhode Island game, you know, with more bodies upright to play. So. But it didn't work that way. So now we just got to, you know, attack the rest. And the reality is we're 4-2. 1-2 in conference, we're 4-2. And we need to find a way to get to 5-2 next week or 2 weeks from now.
Coach, appreciate your time. We'll talk to you in a couple weeks.
All right, thanks, guys.
Paul Worrilow with us now. And Paul, that's a difficult way to lose a football game, obviously. They come down, first time they touch a football, able to move it down the field. What did you see on that opening drive where Maine was able to have success with some of the short passes?
Just poor fundamentals. I mean, we knew what to expect. I think, yeah, they were going into the wind. And, you know, we've been a good run defense, so we expected some short passes. And, you have to come up and be able to make the play and come in and stop it, and we didn't do that.
How tough is it when the offense is struggling the way they were to know as a defense there's very little leeway? You don't have many points that you can give up and still stay in this game.
Yeah, I mean, but that's something we can't control. And, you know, we stress that if we got to play them all game, if we got to go 100 snaps, we'll go 100 snaps. So, I mean, that's not in our control. And, we, you know, regardless of how they're playing, we're going to feel the pressure to go 3 and outs every time.
This is a tough time to have a bye after 2 straight performances like the team has turned in. You are one of the leaders on this team. What do you say to the guys to try to rally them and get them ready for what's going to be a tough process?
Just stay after them, you know, get in their ear that, you know, there is going to be some, we're going to start to feel the pressure. And, yeah, we got a bye, but that doesn't mean, you know, 3-4 days off away from this thing. You know, that's not what we need right now. We got to have everyone to, you know, buy in 100% and get this back going on the right track.
Is there one specific area on the defense that you guys feel like you need to improve a little bit over these next 14 days?
The biggest thing we've been stressing is discipline so far. We've been pretty undisciplined game in and game out. And when you get into conference games, it shows. I mean, we're playing good teams regardless of their record or who they lost to. Everyone in this conference is going to be able to take advantage of that, and that's definitely something that, you know, we showed today.
Paul, appreciate the time. You're still 4-2. Good luck after the bye.
Thank you.